Welcome to this What Is video. I'm the IT Godfather Calvin Zito, and I've worked in enterprise IT for over 40 years. In this video, we're going to look at what is a GPU server. At the end of the video, I'll give you a clickable link to a page that dives deeper, and along the way, there are going to be some helpful links at the top right of the screen. So let's jump into it. To understand a GPU server, the starting point is to really understand the difference between a CPU, which stands for Central Processing Unit, and a GPU, which stands for Graphical Processing Unit. A CPU has a smaller number of cores than a GPU. For a server, we're now shipping servers with as many as 64 cores per CPU. There's also memory capacity that's embedded in the CPU that it needs to run its tasks. They are usually for general purpose workloads like web browsing, running applications, including OSs and virtualization, and are better suited for single-threaded tasks and sequential processing. A GPU, on the other hand, can have thousands of cores. It has data parallelism and high memory throughput. GPUs started for high-end graphics and for video rendering, but they're now very popular for AI and scientific workloads. GPUs can have different kinds of cores, some focused on real-time computing, 3D graphics, and data science, and others are designed for mathematical matrix operations, which are needed for AI and HPC workloads. So with that understanding, we can now look at what is a GPU server. In the HPE portfolio, a GPU server does have CPUs, as there are tasks like the OS and other apps that the CPUs are still needed to run. But for someone who's looking for a GPU server, they're focused on running GPU-centric workloads like training, image processing, speech recognition, natural language processing, autonomous systems, and more. There's a lot more to explore on our What is a GPU server page. After the initial definition, you'll see this section where you can explore questions like, what are the benefits of a GPU server? What are the needs of a GPU server? When do you need a GPU server? And how HPE can help. And if you scroll down further, you'll see a much more detailed look at the difference between CPUs and GPUs than I went into in this video. Here's that link to the What Is page, and here's a playlist of all my What Is videos that you can check out. Please like the video and hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any future videos. Thanks for watching this What Is video.